The TJU presents a flawless production of Part 7. In this episode, I'll be the narrator, Sonya, Shang Tsung, and Chan.
And I'll be Johnny Cage, Kano, Raiden, Liu Kang,
Katana.
Oh, I think this is.
The, I couldn't I get her right.
Kano moment. I know.
I couldn't get her. I couldn't do the female Asian accent.
It's just do typical. I'm a girl. That's fine.
Katana.
Interior. Liu's room. Night. Liu sits on the floor, lit by a single candle, meditating. Begin flashback as he relives his nightmare. Exterior hill, near village, day. Shang Tsung stands over Chan's body, extending his talon-like hand above Chan's head, wrenching the soul from the body. We see the soul drawn from Chan's corpse, which seems to call his brother, Liu! Interior. Liu's room, night. The flashback ends. Liu stares at the flickering flame, then senses a presence outside, rises and slides open the door to the garden. Exterior. Little garden, night. Raiden sits on an ornamental rock, waiting for Liu, who joins him.
I'm sorry for what I said. I am not here for apologies. What are you gonna do now? I don't know. I thought I had it figured out. But I'm not like my ancestors. I don't get this stuff. You won't win just trying to be like your ancestors. What about Katana, then? Can she help me? Perhaps. But there is someone else you should trust first. Someone who has been trained for this day. Someone with a sharp mind and a fierce will. Who? Who, he asks. The TJU. Oh, sorry. You dolt. How can I defeat a sorcerer like Shang Tsung? Almost said the king.
You went real Asian in that line.
Your problem is you spend your life running from who you really are. Everything you need to win is within your grasp, but you must learn to trust your judgment. It will guide you to victory and out of the cubbies.
Could you? Raiden peers into Liu's eyes, looking for some glimmer of hope that he has chosen well. He thinks, just for a second, that maybe he sees that glimmer. Then he vanishes. Liu walks back to his room and steps inside. His eyes go to the single candle burning brightly there. Exterior, Liu Kang's village, day. In the dream sequence, the figure of Shang stands over Chan's body. A strange aura forms around the sorcerer, and the same strange cacophonous chorus of tormented voices cries out. Did you hear me through all that just now?
Something.
It's my thing beeped like a connection.
Oh, no, I heard.
Okay, excuse me, everybody. Shang extends his hand, talon-like, above Chan's head, then pulls back as if yanking something out of it. Why he repeats this. Just for a moment, we see some ethereal matter rise from the body. It's like they rewrote it because they didn't like it, but it was in the script. As the voices reach a crescendo, then, Liu! Shang turns and looks straight into the dream's soul. Hang on a second.
Did it just copy and paste the same thing? No.
It's no, because it's like there's no conversation, so it's like they kind of changed their mind or something. But it's part. Do you want to skip it?
Yeah, it's the same shit, so yeah. Just.
Yeah. I'll do. Okay, here we go. Exterior, the island, panorama on. I didn't notice that. A huge red. what that's supposed to be? A huge red sign that begins to appear above the fog. Exterior, near cliff, dawn.
I think it meant sun. A huge red sun begins to appear above
maybe,
the fog.
Maybe, yeah. Sonya walks into the early light, lost in thought. She spies a lone figure in the mist, performing an intricate and impressive kata. Fuck yeah, the White Ranger kata. A martial arts form with grace, speed, and power using a three-piece sectional staff. I tried to get you to do that, buddy, and you never did.
Buddy, I did three of them, right?
I even... I even sent you the video that inspired it that I used to watch as a kid, the Green Ranger kata on VHS. The sectional staff whistles and whirls around the figure's body. She approaches the figure, silhouetted by the rising sun through the mist, and recognizes him.
Johnny?
Johnny stops, the staff sections folding back into his palm as if they had a life of their own. Click, click. Click, click, boom! He turns and comes
to you. Imagine?
His... his...
quick note, I heard that song again the other day, and it still fucking holds up.
Yeah, saliva was good. His black gi is bathed in sweat from long exertion.
Oh, I thought...
Go ahead, say it. You're impressed.
She smiles. It's a nice smile.
Ha! Is that a smile?
A beat. Neither speaks, but...
I wanted to talk to you. I came by your room last night, but you were out.
I was here.
You've been practicing all night?
And thinking.
I'm sorry about your friend, Arlene. He wasn't my friend. He was your friend, Arlene.
I mean, he was more of an associate, but... I never had time for friends. Art was just a decent guy. I don't know what it's like to lose someone close like Lou. Or you. I heard you talking about your partner the other night. Sorry.
She falls silent, then decides to confide.
He was more than my partner. We were engaged to be married.
What?
Johnny is really... Yeah, I read this, and I was like, what? Is the ring go this far? I'm glad they didn't. Johnny is...
His name was Stryker.
Could you imagine? So, Johnny is really rocked back. He searches for words, finds none.
He was the only man I ever trusted.
What happened?
He went into a building after Kena without waiting for backup. I guess he didn't think he could count on me.
So now you go in alone. No backup. No overprotective guy.
She doesn't respond for a second and tries to throw it off.
Something like that.
When did it happen?
It's been 2 years. Time enough. Time enough to get on with my life. I'm gonna add that two then there.
Yeah. But you haven't, dumb bitch.
She shrugs. Buddy. She shrugs. It's difficult. She shrugs, looks out at the view.
Now you know what I'm doing here. What about you? Was Raiden right? Are you afraid you're just a phony?
I want to prove I'm the best. Is that so complicated?
You're a big fat phony. A couple million fans already think you are. Can they be wrong?
Yeah. Maybe. I'm just tired of bluffing my way through life.
Who'd have thought Johnny Cage isn't a fan of Johnny Cage?
Well, maybe it's time for me to become one. I've got an idea. I've got an idea. I could make a difference here.
That's not his fault. There's
I've got
in this part. There's just some words missing.
Yeah, I've got an idea. I can make a difference here. That makes no sense.
I'm pretty sure that it's. I can make a difference. I've got an idea how I can make a difference here.
Oh man,
it's just missing. Because the mind line had one word missing too.
Yeah. Well, maybe it's time for.
Look, you're one of the best fighters I've ever seen. So you fight that dude with the weird lobster hands? It was crazy. You've just got to fight your own way. Be yourself, but don't do anything stupid.
Whoa. Are you worried about me?
This is just gonna be Family Guy shit, isn't it?
Yep. You're being absurd. Why would I worry about you?
You are worried. You like me.
You are the most egotistical, self-deluded person I've ever met.
Infuriated, she wheels and leaves him there.
Oh, yeah. She's crazy about me. See, now that's Johnny, not that bitch from earlier.
He's done a couple of lines like that. Exterior, tournament grounds, second day. In another long traveling shot, we see that the mood among the remaining few competitors from Earth is very somber as they prepare for combat. Exterior, grounds, Sonya's bout. Sonya, best bout machine. Sonya is waiting impatiently in her fighting area. Lou approaches. Have you seen Johnny?
No. Why?
Fuck some of these characters. Just then, she sees Shang approaching her. He and Lou face off, then Shang turns to Sonya. His smile chills her anew. I've arranged a present for you.
I don't want anything from you.
Oh, fuck it, that's lame.
That's not true. There is one thing you want very much. He steps aside, and Sonya sees Kano approaching. Kano gives her the death stare with his one good eye, then turns his back and begins warming up. I should change Shang. He should be like, I arranged this match for you. I know how impatient you've become. I have every confidence you'll win.
He's your stooge.
But of limited use as my queen and consort.
In your dreams?
Nearly all of my dreams have already come true. Shang steps back, and the mute monk comes forward to begin the bout. Kano swaggers forward.
I think they mean to say mute Baraka comes forward.
Yeah, they're all Barakas.
Sonya, stay cool. How you doing, babe? Did you miss me?
So excited, I bet, for the line coming up.
Sonya, 6 years.
God damn it! Sonya is deeply conflicted between the hate she feels for Kano and Shang's words. The mute monk withdraws. The two circle warily. Kano and Sonya trade blows. She batters his face with a quick series of round kicks. Kano lunges, misses, rolls, and comes up with a knife from his boot. He smiles.
Now this baby brings back memories.
Let me guess. You use it to knife your mother in the back?
Guess again. Put a big smile on your boyfriend. Ear to ear.
For applause. Sonya's face goes white with rage. She searches for something to defend herself.
Sonya!
Lou tosses her a pair of bamboo fighting sticks, Eskrimas, to defend herself as Kano expertly probes her defenses with the boot knife.
That's the spirit. I like a mean and feisty.
Sonya kicks him in the balls. Then she attacks with a flurry of blows. Wait, and the battle is on in earnest. Shang looks on with interest. The fight continues until both opponents are tired and sweating. Finally, she disarms him with the fighting sticks, and he uses his strength to break the bamboo batons. Barehanded, Kano uses his superior size and strength to gain an advantage.
Don't go head-to-head with him. Fight smart.
Sonya doesn't take her eyes off Kano, but she nods. When he moves in again, she uses Aikido to nullify his charge.
That's it!
But Kano is a savvy street fighter. Isn't it Street Fighter? He knows Aikido too. And suddenly, tables have turned. He has Sonya in a powerful hammer lock.
Kano, fire!
Can you imagine? Shang becomes tense. Kano looks to him for permission to kill her, knowing it won't be granted. Shang shakes his head. Resume bout. Kano looks like he just might do it anyway. He exerts more pressure on her neck. I feel like a burp's coming on. It's fucking me up. She brings a heel crushing down on his instep. He yowls in pain as she repositions a leg, swivels her feet, and throws him off of her. She kicks him twice in the face, dazing him. Then she does a springing handstand, catches Kano's neck between her legs, and throws him to the ground, squeezing tighter and tighter, strangling him.
Sonya, that's what he wants!
Shang beams with pleasure. The same strange aura begins to form around him, the same dissonant music of voices in anguish. That's right. Finish him! Pay me tribute with his death. The aura becomes brighter, more intense. His claw hand begins to reach in to take Kano's warrior soul.
So he's got a claw too?
I think he's just kind of like...
He's cupping his hand.
He's cupping his hand, yeah, okay. Like a talon.
Okay.
I hope. Sonya stares down at the struggling Kano, his face bright red, his exertions weakening. She could kill him now.
If you do it, Shang will own you.
She realizes he's right. No! She releases Kano from the death grip. He flops weakly onto the ground, defeated. Sonya stands, looks down on him, then turns and walks away. Shang returned to his normal... Maybe it was a claw. Shang returned to his normal form, steps in front of her, barring the way.
Yeah, come on. Give me a break.
I can't not with the way. Kills me, dude. You disappoint me. That isn't wise. Raiden appears. He has seen everything.
She doesn't answer to you, sorcerer.
Shang's eyes flash with anger, then he bows almost mockingly. Quite right, Lord Raiden. But one day soon, she will. All of you will. And Shang sweeps off. Lu approaches Sonya.
You okay?
She holds up her fists. He touches them with his. Exterior grounds, various day. In a brief kinetic montage, we see that Lu's prediction about the fights is true. Several human combatants are shown in tight close-up crashing to the ground, defeated by the warriors of Outworld.
Oh, fuck yeah, they kept it.
Yeah, they kind of use that for Goro.
Yeah.
Exterior island, various angles, late afternoon. The sun has swung through its arc and now throws long shadow from the buildings and statues. Suddenly, we hear it. A faint echo.
Goro! Goro!
The island echoes with the cool and the other fighters here. The monks look curiously around.
Goro! Goro!
Exterior, statuary garden, late afternoon. Johnny falls silent and waits among the lost shadows of ancient warriors. Shang appears at the far end of the garden near the Great Hall. What do you want?
An Oscar and a film with Michelle Pfeiffer. But I'll settle for that big forearm, some bitch.
You are challenging Goro.
What? I need a written invitation? Yeah, I'm challenging him. Here. Now.
You are very foolish.
You get you foolish. That's what people say.
I'm trying to be Shang Tsung.
No, okay.
God damn it. Very well.
Goro approaches.
Goro in his Jeep Wrangler approaches.
Yeah, it has to be something with the top. This thing's like stick out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fuck.
Very well. I will grant your demand. But as a former champion, I reserve the right to challenge.
Yeah, the winner. You got it.
The winner or another of my choosing. At the place appointed by me for the final battle.
No.
You.
Raiden materializes furious.
Uh-oh.
You there?
Oh, there you are. I lost you for a second.
I said my line. I said no.
Okay. All right. Raiden materializes, furious. The rules were quite clear, Lord Raiden.
He didn't know. Withdraw your challenge.
Too late, I'm afraid. How do you say, a deal's a deal? Shang turns and walks away.
What have you done? Exercise my own free will. Made a choice. I thought you'd be pleased. Or was that just a crock? Are you mocking me? No, I'm telling you to go away. Get lost. This is our tournament, remember? Mortal Kombat. We fight it.
Raiden stands mutely appraising Johnny. Behind him, other fighters, including Sonya and Lu, have gathered.
What's he done? Made a choice. At least one of you understood.
Oh, she came out of nowhere.
Yep.
Your turn will come.
The stillness is shattered by a terrible sound, Goro's ferocious roar. The crowd parts. Prince Goro appears in the tunnel entrance. He raises his arms and roars his savage challenge again.
You're gonna hurt yourself doing that.
Goro stops to consider the man in front of him. He reaches for the buckle to loosen his cape.
Strange. We've just met and already I don't like you.
If you don't like me now, wait till later.
End of part 7.